for Bachelor's in Psychology at St. Louis University, Baguio City in 2002. She obtained her Masterate in Education, Major in Guidance and Counseling at the Tarlac State University in 2013. To date, she's taking her Doctorate in Philosophy, Major in Development Education and Centralism State University. Wolf ko daw kung sasabihin that she's married with one son. And our speaker is the beautiful daughter of Mr. Angelito Unsod. Kahit ayaw nilang sabihin ko yon, our upstart advisor. Huwag ko rin daw kung sabihin that she's 33 years old. Kasi if you look at her, she's younger. No, she's much, much younger than her age. She is the Don Bosco Technical Institute Guidance Counselor. Friends, up on your hands for Mrs. Clarice Angela Monsod Caldez, RGC. Nakikita niyo po ba ako kapag nandito? Okay, dito na lang po ako no, later dyan. Before I will start our seminar for this afternoon, ang akin po kasi module is on career guidance and eventually, consequently, career counseling. I will ask for two volunteers na tutulong sa akin dito sa harap. Huwag po kayo mag-alala, hindi ko po kayo tatanungin ng board exam questions. Hindi pa po, malayo pa po. Kailangan ko po ng two volunteers, isang male at isang female. Sige na po, ang guidance counselors hindi na kailangan pinipilit. Ang guidance counselors, empowered, dynamic. Pag sinabing volunteer, gumagagad na dito na. No? Sino po ang sumag-volunteer? Isang female at isang male. Thank you po. Arayan po nagtataas ng kamay. Pero dalawa lang po ang kailangan ko. Isa-isa lang po. Siguro dito kuha tayo ng ano? Kuha tayo ng male. No. So kawawa naman yung mga kakilala ko. Si Sir! Nag-meet kami ni Sir kanina. No? Si Sir, uy, thank you Sir ha. Nakaya naman. Uy, pero ano lang ah, konti lang mga mamaya hanggang 3 o'clock na magsalita. And then dito po, sino po? Female. Ayan. Siguro yung mga medyo ano naman dito, yung mga hindi mo kakilala. Sino kaya? Lahat nakatingin sa baba. Bakit may sinabi na ba ako? Meron na po ba kayong tinitake down dyan? Hindi nyo pa nga alam yung topic natin eh. Ayun, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Sige po, kayo na po. Yung nakakulay brown. Uy, colorblind na sila niya. Yung katabi ni Sir. Sir, opo, yung katabi niyo po yung sinasabi ko. The beautiful lady in brown. Ma'am, may we invite you here? Sir, yung katabi mo, colorblind ka ba? Ayun siya, brown siya. Mga lalaki daw po usually colorblind. Do you know that? Siya po yung proof natin. Thank you, ma'am. Ayan, ayun po kayo. Naku, napakadali lang naman po ito. Ito lang. Ang topic kasi natin for this afternoon is career guidance. So ano ba naman ang most fitting way to start our seminar this afternoon is to ask. Epan, by the way, guidance counselor po ba kayo? Guidance counselor po? Ay, hindi po. Registrar. Ano ba, guidance counselor? Ay, opo. Kayo po, sir, guidance counselor. So ang tanong ko po, ma'am, bakit guidance counselor ang naging trabaho? Paki-share naman po. Sir, ganun din po sa inyo, ha?
Pang 3 years ko pa lang po sa school namin. Tsaka, sabi po nila, not for boasting po, pero medyo, kapag nagtuturo po kasi ako, sinasamahan ko ng, medyo religious siya, gano'n. Kaya pinili po nila ako maging guidance counselor siguro. Yun po. Tsaka bago lang po yung bago po yung administrator sa school.
I'm very sorry, I did not get your name. No? Ano na po pangalan ni ma'am?
Leia po.
Si ma'am Leia. Kaya po kayo naging guidance counselor kasi feeling nila, sa tingin nila, ang impression nila sa inyo, mabait ka. Ganun din po yung impression sa akin. Uy, bakit po kayo tumatawa? Nakaka-hurt po. Okay. So, thank you, ma'am, ha? At mukha naman talagang mabait si Miss Leia. Do you agree? Yes. Of course. Thank you, Miss Leia. Ayan. Si sir naman. Oh, sir, huwag mo naman kukopya. Ano naman, iba naman. Okay. Bakit po guidance counselor kayo sa school niyo? Bakit yun yung kinuha niyo? At hindi principal?
Ayan po. Una po, kung kay ma'am kanina, siya po yung administration po yung pipili sa kanya. Ako po yung nag-volunteer. Ayun po, gusto ko po mag-volunteer as a guidance counselor kasi yun po yung wala sa akin. Yung, kumbaga, sa totoo lang po, gusto ko po sana na mas maging friendly sa mga estudyante, mas maging open sa mga estudyante. Para naman po mas maintindihan ko kung ano yung mga needs po nila bilang estudyante po.
Thank you very much, sir. Si sir, ano po pangalan nila? Biolo? Si Sir Roel. Thank you, Sir Roel, sa kami, Miss Leia. Okay. Mapapansin niyo po, magkaiba po yung reason. And that is very evident and very usual. Hindi lang sa kanilang dalawa, hindi lang sa ating matatanda, but most especially to our students. To our pupils and students. That is why for this afternoon, we should be having what we call career guidance seminar. So titignan po natin, I have three topics, all in all, intertwined po siya to make a beautiful picture of how you can help your students decide the best course for their future. Ang first po, ayan. Ang first topic po natin is, we will be talking about theory. A theory in career guidance. We shall be talking about it. We shall be having some activities and some sharing. But first, why do we have to start our seminar with a theory? Nakasulat po dyan sa ating naka-project na slide. It is for us to have a conceptual view or a theoretical basis. Dapat po for us counselors, whenever we do something, it has to be founded by theories. Or else, our activities will not make sense. No, hindi po porke nagising ka isang araw, gusto kong pag-usapan to. Gusto ko ganyan. Kumisan po, when we have this kind of activities na out of the blue, sometimes it is effective, sometimes they are not effective. So, para iwasan natin yung mga ganun na trial and error, we might as well make our activities based on theories. That is why we shall be starting this seminar with the theories. No? Ang mga career guidance seminar, career guidance theories are divided into three. The first one is theories concerned with the counseling process. There are two very famous. I shall not be discussing them because, surprise, ito po yung content ng board exam, no? Don't worry po, malapit yun na po silang makilala. For this afternoon, we shall only be talking about one. Career guidance in a board exam is very interesting and very relevant to us. Because for those guidance counselors in the profession for many years, usually talaga ito yung ating main function sa school, career guidance. We shall be discussing very briefly theories concerned with the developmental process. The first theory is the lifespan theory by Donald Super. Yan po yung i-discuss natin. We have plenty more of theories, pero hindi na po natin sila pag-uusapan ngayon because as I said, they will have a special place in your hearts later on. We also have theories of content. So the theories in career guidance are divided into three. Theories concerning counseling process, developmental process, and theories concerning the content. Let's start. Under the theories concerned with the developmental process is the lifespan, life stage theory. Ito po kasi ang pinakasikat. Kasi ito yung medyo talaga nakaka-relate tayo, hindi lang yung mga bata. Because this theory would be from birth until yun, death. Nakakalungkot naman, no? So our proponent for this theory is Donald Super. He himself defined careers as the sequence and combination of roles that a person plays during the course of a lifetime. Napaka-importante po kay Donald Super ang ibig sabihin ng self-concept. What is self-concept? Makikita po sa slide. Iba yung nakikita niya sa sarili niya.
Yeah.
Do you think that is positive? I would like to think that that is a positive self-concept about that. Kunyari person siya, no? Ibig sabihin, tao po ako siya. Yan. Pero he sees himself as the king. That is what we call self-concept. When we talk about Donald Super's theory, it all revolves about self-concept and how we practice or apply the self-concept in our careers. Sabi ni Donald Super, self-concept changes over time. What we see of ourselves when we were younger is far different than how we see ourselves now. Diba? Tama po, no? May pagkakaiba naman po sana, no? Dati ang tingin mo sa sarili mo, iba. Ngayong medyo matured ka na, iba din. So it is it changes over time. At the same time, self-concept develops as a result of our experience. Kaya siya nagbabago because of the positive and negative experiences that we undergo all throughout our lifetime. And because of that, Donald Super said that career development is lifelong. Hindi porke ang isang bata, he was able to go to a perfect course in college, hindi ibig sabihin career development stops there. Career development is lifelong, even with us, mature people already. Napansin ko po kanina, you are seated very comfortably with your seatmates. Naisip ko, medyo gagawa tayo ng something different, no? Okay. But before we go into that, tingnan natin. Here are Super's developmental self-concept theory. Sinummarize ko na lang po siya because I would like us to concentrate on the application and sharing of this theory. First, he said that vocational development is the process of developing and implementing a self-concept. Super believed that our identities and by our extension, our careers, are a product of how we see ourselves and how we implement this self-concept in the real world. So napaka-importante sa kanya. When we say vocational development, it is all about how we saw ourselves and how we are able to live that self-concept in the real world. Second, for him, as the self-concept becomes more realistic and stable, so does vocational choice and behavior. Later on, makikita niyo po, meron pong stages na pinagdadaanan ang bawat isa sa atin when it comes to vocational maturity. He also said that people choose occupations that permit them to express their self-concept. Kaya tayo pumupunta sa isang trabaho because that job enables us to implement or put into practice what we think of ourselves. Therefore, kapag ang isang tao nagagawa niya or nai-implement niya ang self-concept niya, magkakaroon siya ng work satisfaction. Tama po ba? Kapag yung job na ginagawa mo, yun ay isang realization ng iyong lifelong dream for yourself, therefore, it is expected that you are happy in your vocation. Therefore, it is expected that that work for you is not only a profession, not only a career, not only a work. It is a vocation. No? Ito po ang gagawin natin. Kailangan nyo na po mag-break into small groups. No? Kasi napansin ko, medyo tanghali na at alam naman po natin pag tanghali, kailangan natin gumalaw-galaw. We are going to discuss Super's 5 life and career development stages. Ang gagawin natin, I will group you into 4 groups. Okay? What are we going to do in those 4 small groups? First, kukuha tayo ng leader. Siya yung magfa-facilitate ng discussion. We shall be discussing siguro roughly 5 to 10 minutes lang. The first question or the first thing that you have to do as a group is determine ano yung characteristic ng group nyo in terms of career. I shall be grouping you by age bracket po. This age bracket is based on Super's career stages. So una-una yung gagawin nyo. Ano ang career characteristic ng group or age bracket nyo. The second one is, you have to determine ano ang goal ng isang tao nasa age bracket na yun. Okay? The first group will be those people who are fresh graduates, meaning 20 to 25 years old. You should be proceeding here, mamaya, no? The second group would be those people who are 25 to 45 years old. No need to show your NSO birth certificate. No, we trust you. They should be, we will be placing them doon sa may iba na likod. The next step doon sa kabilang likod would be our counselors 46 to 65 years old. And of course, yung mga 66 and above po, they shall be staying here. Pwede na po ba natin gawin yon? Can we go to our groups, please? Ulitin ko lang po, 20 to 25 dito sa harapan. 26 to 45 sa likuran. Sa likuran din po, 46 to 65 and our last po. Please, try to look at each other. Magalo na lang po tayo, no? Let's be flexible. So that we could discuss as a group. Choose the leader. Who is the leader of this group? Okay. And then, dito po, 46 to 65. Okay. 46 to 65, please choose a leader. And of course, our private group. Ay, si Mama. Okay, so meron na po tayong leader. Again, the first question or the first task for you to do is to determine what is the career characteristic of your group. Pagdating sa career, sino ang mga 20 to 25 years old? Paano sila na-distinguish? Hindi ba din sasabihin sa inyo? No, di ba? Ang mayroon pa. No? So, di ba din mga isa-isa? Ano ang common sa inyo pagdating sa career? And the second task is for you to determine ano ang career goal mo kapag ikaw ay fresh graduate. Okay? Eto na yung goal mo. Para kayo ang student. O, dito naman po. Uy, nakikinigin na kayo. Kapag adotek ni sa counseling dito. Ano kayo mga professor X na? Discuss kayo. O, sige po. Dito rin po po eh. Diba? Kasi 25 na po. Sino ba yung leader niyo? Ay, si Manali. Sige na, ma. Hindi po kayo matatapos pag wala kayong English class, no? Pag sinabi po 26 to 45, paano po kayo na-distinguish sa place of work? Di ba po meron po tayong characteristic kapag nasa ganyan yung dami na tayo? Pag-usapan po natin yun ng may sound. Ang may sound. Very specific po, ha? Sino po ang leader natin? Mama, pwede po ba na yung harapan niya? Kapag po nasa ganitong age bracket na, how do we characterize ourselves in terms of career persons? No? Ano na usually yung mga tapak namin sa trabaho kapag 46 to 65 years old na tayo? Sino po yung, ma'am, would you like to be the leader of your group? Please, kung para mag-facilitate yun. You only have 10 minutes. My time is 1:25.
Yung isang bagay, susundin ako, o baka di manalina ko ng estudyante. Nandun na tayo sa, kailangan pa natin ipakilala kung sino tayo. O, nandun na tayo sa, kilala na tayo. Yung binabalita na tayo, kasana ba tayo doon?
Okay. Aside from
More on yourself. More on guidance po ba ang hawak? Or may teaching guidance po? May teaching po. So, more on guidance na hindi po ba lahat? Ano po sila? Mabe teacher and guidance designated po. So, sa tingin po ninyo, sir, bakit po kayo naging guidance designated po?
Okay. We should be starting from the youngest, no? We followed by the next age bracket. We should be having very brief sharing of what they have talked about a while ago. Kanina, ano, una parang kaaway na sila, pero naging okay naman, no? Ganun na, di ba kapag counselors tayo, we are full of energy. Yun ang unang trait ng guidance counselor, kapag lemyak-lemyak ka, paano na, di ba? So tamang-tama yung nakita kong personality traits sa kanilang group. Ma'am, would you like to share your group's output? Just a brief introduction of yourself, name, and the school you're affiliated with.
Hello. Good afternoon po. I'm Miss Rowena Ramos from Osha's Colleges. Tinatawag po namin yung group namin as yung pabukang bulaklak pala. Ayaw. Flowers. Bakit po kaya ayaw flowers? Kasi bagong graduate pa lang. Fresh grad. Okay? Wala pa po kaming idea sa napasukan namin. But, yung puso po namin ay nandun. Okay? The question is, ano ba yung characteristic ng fresh graduate as a guidance counselor? Sa amin, as a young, syempre, lively. Okay? Kailangan mong maging energetic. As a guidance counselor, pagpasok ng bata, hindi pwede siya yung uunang, good morning! Good morning! Okay? Hindi pwede sabihin ng guys, good morning class, good morning kids. Okay? Kailangan lively. Trustworthy. Pinagkakatiwalaan ang guidance counselor. Kung bata pa ako, naalala ko pag guidance counselor, takot na takot ako sa guidance. Kasi natatakot po kami na ang guidance, pag na-guidance ka, sabi magkakaroon ka ng record, hindi ka mag-graduate. Okay. Approachable. Mabait din. Then, kontra po ba kayo doon? Tayo po ay mabait po, di ba? Okay. Next is career goal. As a fresh graduate po, ang napag-usapan po namin na goal po namin is since nagsisimula pa lang po kami, ang goal pa lang po namin ang gusto lang po namin ay makatapos ng aming master degree at makaupo po dun sa isang silya. Doon po sa isang silya ng office na kami po ay nagka-career planning sa mga bata at nagbibigay ng advice. Not only, hindi lang po bilang ako po, teacher po ako. Okay? Pangarap po namin din na magbigay din po kami ng isang inspirasyon. Okay. Sa mga kasama ko, anything? Okay. Last. Ang grupo po namin ay tinawag po namin na parang nagsisimula pa lang po na bulaklak. Kasi po, nag-absorb pa lang po kami ng idea or knowledge sa kapwa po namin. So, pag po ito ay na-absorb po namin, kami po ay unti-unting bumubukar. Okay? Natututunan para po makatulong din po kami sa aming siblings. At sa mga
ako sa posisyon. Yan po yung mga kadalasan, no? Yan yung mga punong-punong ng energy. Isang ito, no? Yung mga ginaganyan natin. Ang next group po natin, let's welcome to represent them, Ma'am Vin. Dito po.
Kailangan energetic.
Dapat energetic. Good afternoon! Ganun dapat. Okay, mabuhay! Okay, I represent my group from ages 26 to 45. Okay. Ang tanong po sa amin, dalawa, kung kami ba ay satisfied na sa aming trabaho and ano pa ang career goal namin. Karamihan po kanina, tinanong ko kung sila po ba yung guidance designee or sila ay full-time guidance counselors. Halo po, meron pong mga designee, meron yung mga may teaching load pa rin. So, magkaganon man po, meron na po kaming na-build na foundation, nakakilala na kami dun sa school na pinagtatrabahuhan namin. Na kapag kami dun, dumating kami ay established na, kilala na, na kami ay ginagalang na, hindi na kami pinagtatanong kung sino ba yung teacher yun. Pag kami dumating, yun si Ma'am Hano, yun. Yun si Ma'am Vina. Pwede mong lapitan yun anytime. Diba? Yung mga ganun na naririnig na kami sa aming mga estudyante. And then yung aming career goal, more on satisfied na kami. Wala nang career shifting na nasa aming pag-iisip. So, kung nasan kami ngayon, contented kami. Nagsasalita po ako in behalf kung sakali mang meron pong ano. Okay. Yung iba po kasi meron matagal nang nasa guidance po. And yung iba na naka-designate, tinanong ko po kung mahal naman po nila yung trabaho nila. Ayan na po. Of course, sino po ang mag-represent? Yes, madam. From the 46 to 65 group, career group. Palakpakan po natin.
If you look at me, I'm still strong. I'm representing 46 to 70 years old. Akala ko 65 lang. Okay, I'm 69. But there is one more ahead of me over there. I'm happy about that. This time, I'm a loser. Okay, my first interview with my mates. More happy, contented, and still serving with commitment. More active in serving, understanding, open-minded. Nakakapagpasensya. More challenge, more confident. Noong una daw na panahon, long, long ago, pag tinignan daw niya ang estudyante niya, ganon. Gumaganon yung estudyante. Pero ngayon na, pag sinabi mo, challenging talaga, no? So, it is really more challenging. But he said, he can accept the challenge very well now. Because he is more confident, he is more experienced, and he has more power. Right? Sa mga kulubot ng mukha, medyo takot na yung bata. Yes, it is already intrinsic. It's already in the personality. Even just by our walk, the way we walk, and the way we talk, the student has already convinced himself that he must believe in this person. That is my experience too, even with parents. Pag umanon lang kami, that's it. That's the beauty of being old. Yeah. Praise the Lord for that. So, we are more confident. And we stand on situations that are challenging, but we are more stable in our emotions. Wala kaming pinapakitang tremor. Okay? Like that. Now, children, you listen. And that's it. They will listen. Greater knowledge due to our experience, balanced with academ, like this. We attend the masteral classes and also seminars like this. Of course, we are more devoted. Like a parent, we believe that we are more parents to these children, like their own parents. Right? Parang nanay, parang lola. Madalas, parang lola. However, to learn more at this point in our time, because there are plenty of legalistic issues related to disciplining a child, like respect for human rights, yung pagpapalo, pag-umurot, or libel. We are faced with those kinds of problems as counselors, right? Yes. So, kami, maski na matanda na kami, gusto pa rin namin matutunan ang mga ito na developments sa ating legalistic points of view in our country. There were some problems, issues, or situations in the past that happens during our life as counselors. They should now be given more importance and they are better handled now. Like, a child who is molested in the classroom. These are quite new issues which did not happen in the past. Or if it happened in the past, dahil nahihiya lang yung bata o yung parent, hindi na niya rinalabas ito. Now, these things now should be handled better by our senior counselors. I believe in that. With the help of the DSWD, the police, DepEd, what more else? Okay, and most importantly, our goals as counselors is to serve better, even without compensation. At the moment, I don't receive any compensation as a counselor of our school. But I am so happy, and I am so, my heart is full of very sincere commitment to the betterment of the welfare of our students in terms of human behavior, especially on relations with the parents, the community, and of course, especially also to the leaders of our community. So we serve our children, our students, much better now than in the past. Before, it was only in terms of money. Now, it is in terms of commitment.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Sorry, I did not get your name. Madam!
Your name, ma'am.
Ano naman po pangalan nila, madam?
I'm Mrs. Clope Velasco of Victoria Tarlac, Prime Star, Montessori School.
Wow, ang galing, no? Ibang-iba. As I was listening to the sharing, I was taking notes kasi sabi ko, hindi ko na-discuss. Huwag ko na ata i-discuss. Parang okay na yung sharing nyo. Because I ask you to be grouped in such a way because I want to prove to myself that Super's theory is very applicable and relevant to what we call career guidance in our field of profession. So let's start.
we shall be discussing Super's 5 life and career development stages. The first stage would be the growth stage. This stage would start from birth or 7 to 14 age range. Ito yung mga grade 1 to grade 8 students natin. During this time, children begin developing a self-concept based on many factors like actual and perceived physical and mental abilities, roles within the family and relationships with peers. They begin to develop attitudes and beliefs about the world of work, although these are usually based on limited information. As you would see po, sabi nga ni Dr. Davistez kanina, we should be starting career guidance not only during the grade 9 or grade 10, by then it is already too late. We should start career guidance as early as grade 1 or as early as kinder. We have an experience from where I'm working. Nagkaroon sila ng kinder career day. Diba alam niyo naman po yung mga kinder parents ay yung mga madadaling i-convince na ipag-costume ang mga anak. Kapag po kasi high school, tamad na sila na yung mag-costume, ayaw na nila. Pero pag sa kinder, magpapatahin pa talaga sila ng costume. So they had that, no? They paraded around the school in their dream occupation or dream job. Yung mga iba, dahil ang kanyang tatay ay isang military man, it is so predictable that he was dressed as a military man. Meron din mga iba, marami po yung mga doktor. Parang tayo lang, no, nung bata tayo, what is your dream? I want to become a doctor. Usually po sa stage na to, very crucial ang tinatawag nating role of the parents or their occupations. Kaya nga importante for us parents, yung mga parents dito, dapat po sana our kids or our children are aware of what we are doing in our works. Dapat alam man lang nila kung ano yung trabaho natin. Kasi tayo po yung first model of careers. As you will see in this stage, the parents, the families, and the relatives' occupation, the idea on those things are very important for children from 7 to 14 years old. So that is the first stage, the growth stage. The second stage is people from 14 to 25 is the exploratory stage. People begin to more clearly understand various occupations and start to envision themselves in different careers. They are aware of factors like prestige, levels of income, and how their interests and values will fit within a given profession. This is the challenge for those counselors in the high school department because exploratory stage would include the high school to college students. So ano ang ginagawa dito? Please remember, the reason why we are talking about this, let me reiterate, dapat yung mga activities natin supporting the stages. So for example, you are a high school career counselor or career advocate, please make sure that your activities are about exploring. Kasi nandun sila. Huwag ka magbigay ng growth. Medyo maguguluhan sila dyan. Please stick to the stages, no? The characteristics of people in the exploratory stage would be trying out, sinusubukan. Mahilig silang sumubok ng mga kung ano-anong bagay. They do that through classes, through work experiences. Nakakaroon pa nila ng work experience. Of course, di ba kaya sa college merong OJT? That is where they explore in their OJT or in their training. And also through their hobbies. Sabi ni Super, when we talk about exploratory stage, it is like dipping your toes in the water to see if the water is too hot. No, parang titignan mo muna, oops, malamig ba? Mainit ba? You are not yet ready to go inside the bathtub or to take a bath immediately kasi hindi mo pa alam. You are just trying out. You are just exploring. So please try to remember, we were all 14 to 25 years old. Diba lahat naman tayo is supposed dumaan dyan. We all experienced high school and college. Try to reflect. Nung pag ikaw ay nasa high school and college, were you also adventurous?
to exploration. Diba? Okay. The next one. I would like to use the term Ma'am Vin used kanina. Meron ng foundation. Because the next stage of Super's careers, career stage would be establishment stage. Ito yung 25 to 45 age range. During this phase, a person selects a job and starts working. He compares his self-concept to the job he is at and either decides it is a good fit or looks for alternatives. Ito na naman yung self-concept, lumabas na naman. Kapag ikaw ay nasa 25 to 45, mag-iisip ka na, dito ba talaga ako? Kasi kapag dito ka na, kapag may foundation ka na, you're already established. Kaya siya establishment stage. The characteristics of this stage would be entry-level skills building and stabilization through work experience. The first thing that you would notice is that, kaya pinakamarami sila eh, because this stage would last ilang years? 20 years. So ito yung medyo pinakamatagal. When someone decides to come to therapy, it usually means that he or she is searching. Ito yung stage na medyo mag-aalinlangan ka and it is normal for you to feel that way. Because searching is a vital point of the human condition and it should be fostered, not suppressed. Kapag meron po tayong kasamahan na parang medyo nagiging mareklamo na siya or medyo naghahanap na siya sa, ano ba yun, ano ba yung jobstreet.com, normal lang po yun. No? Nasa, kumbaga, humingiti sila. Parang gusto ko atang lumipat ng school o kaya lumipat ng profession. Normal po yun kapag ikaw ay nasa establishment stage. I myself, I tried that, no? When I was siguro roughly 28 years old, I applied at the Comelec, nag-apply ako sa Globe, nag-apply ako sa Sanyo. But I realized at that point that miski maraming options, I prefer to stay where I am until now. So I would say na I'm already established at this point. Okay. The next stage is maintenance stage, the 45 to 65 age range. During this time, most people have settled upon a job or industry that fits them and usually continue to develop skills and interests as they advance through their lives and careers. Sabi nga naman kanina, she used the word very fitting for the maintenance stage. She used the word stable. Kaya kapag nasa maintenance stage ka na, meron kang sense of stability. Kaya nga, di ba nasabi nga niya, maybe even without the compensation, she is willing to do it for service and commitment. So, yun ang tinatawag nating maintenance stage. But according to Super, this is the stage when people are most likely to grow dissatisfied. Kung doon kanina sa establishment stage, parang naghahanap pa ng ibang trabaho, nagbabakasakali, dito sa maintenance stage, may tendency na medyo umayaw sa trabaho. Please take note that this stage is also 20 years, 45 to 65. We did not have a group for the next stage. This stage is called disengagement. Ito yung mga pa-retire. This occurs prior to retirement. Focus on work begins to diminish and this focus moves to concerns about other areas in life. Medyo nag-move away na sila sa mga career challenges and tasks because they are trying to prepare for another stage in their life, which is retirement. In summary, this is the summary grid of Super's career stages from growth, exploration, establishment, maintenance, and decline. Kaya tinan niyo po yung mga nasa age bracket 20 to 25, sila po yung kumukuha ng picture. Pero yung mga ibang age bracket, nagsusulat sila. Nakakatawang observe. Okay. Kay Super po, hindi lang enough na may stages. There are also developmental tasks within the different stages of career. So ang isang adolescent, miski siya ay bata pa lang, meron pa rin siyang pinagdadaan ng growth, exploratory,
establishment, maintenance, and decline. So briefly, let us go through them. An adolescent during growth is developing a realistic self-concept. Tandaan po natin, no, we had already our very own self-concepts ever since. When you are already an adolescent, you are trying to make these self-concepts realistic, makatotohanan. That is their growth task. Exploratory. Adolescents are trying to learn more about opportunities. They are also getting started in a chosen field. Kasi ito na yung stage na mamimili na sila ng course. For the maintenance stage, adolescents are verifying current occupational choices. Sinitignan nila, nag-testing sila. Gusto nila maging doktor, pero mahina sila sa math. Mahina sila sa science. Realistic pa ba? Pwede pa ba? And for their decline, adolescents are giving less time to hobbies. So if you have an adolescent student or adolescent child, it's quite normal for them to give less time to hobbies because this is very characterized by the decline stage. How about the early adulthood? Early adulthood, for them, as a sign of growth, they are learning to relate to others. So hindi na sila puro self-concept lang ang inaatupag, hindi lang ako, ako, ako. Kapag nandun ka na sa early adulthood, you are trying to relate with other people. You are moving away from your inside world. As part of exploratory, you find desired opportunity. Kaya nga yung sinasabi natin kanina, tumitingin ka sa ibang lugar, hindi lang kung nasan ka, you try to look for other things, other interesting things outside your world. As part of the establishment, they are settling down in a suitable position. Maintenance, making occupational position secure. Kaya po yung mga early adults, yan po yung mararamdaman natin, we are highly competitive. Kapag kunyari, di ba, yung may dumating sa HR, tapos bad trip, mag-a-apply guidance, eh nandun ka, I've experienced that, no, pero deep inside, hindi ko na lang sinabi sa HR, pero na-threaten ako when I was younger. Hindi naman open yung guidance, tapos biglang mayroong mag-a-apply na guidance, di ba? Eh, maganda siya. Buti na lang hindi siya tinanggap. Sinirahan ko. And then also, as early adults, during our decline, we reduce sports participation. Ah, meron tayong magandang excuse, ba't di tayo active, no? Kasi decline. Ganyan na lang ang sabihin nyo. How about the middle adults? Ano yung pinagdadaanan nila? They are already accepting one's own limitation. Kapag medyo nasa middle adult ka na, mas kilala mo na yung sarili mo, thus you know what you can do and what you cannot do. So naaano mo na yan, na-verify mo na yan sa sarili mo. As exploratory stage, you are trying to identify new tasks to work on. You develop new skills and you hold one's own against competition. Kapag nandiyan ka na sa stage na yan, as a sign of decline, you are focusing on essentials. You are not already sweating on the small stuffs. No, hindi ka gaya nung bata-bata ka kapag may change of schedule, high blood ka na, bad trip ka na, ayaw na, walk out. Kapag nasa middle adulthood ka na, yung mga ganung bagay, carry na yun, ganun na tayo, no? Now, the last stage is the late adulthood. As a sign of growth, you are developing and valuing non-occupational roles. Hindi na lang puro work. No, nandun ka na palagi sa pamilya mo. Ito ngayon, di ba, yung nagpa-farming ka na. Whether sa totoong farm or sa farm field, yan na yung mga hilig mo. Hindi naman siguro nagsi-COC yung mga late adults, no? Hindi naman siguro. Hindi na sila masyado sa ganyan. They are trying to explore, to find a good retirement place. Saan yung magandang kalalagyan nila later on? O, di ba? Yung mga iba, di pa sila makarelate kasi malayo pa yan sa kanila, no? Pero I'm sure yung mga ibang kasamahan natin, yan ang tumatakbo sa isip nila. They are trying to do things one has wanted to do. Ang tagal ko nang gustong gawin to. Ngayon, magagawa ko na. Kasi meron na akong sense of authority. Meron na akong excuse. Pwede na. They are keeping what one enjoys as a sign of maintenance. And as a sign of decline, late adults are now reducing work hours. So yan ang kanilang sign of decline. So these are the different stages and developmental tasks of super. Marami pang ibang meron, but I decided to choose this one because ito yung popular and most relevant in my opinion. There are a number of vital contributions that Super has made to the arena of career development. Number one, for him, he said that people are not being fixed but changing over time. Ang ibig sabihin ng sinabi ni Super na ito ay, career is ongoing and developmental, not tied to a single one or a choice made in the past. Kung dati gusto mo maging doktor, huwag kang malungkot kung nagbago yan, because that is normal. Kung dati gusto mong doktor, ngayon gusto mo na maging engineer, that's okay because you are being influenced by a lot of factors. Number two, super see who we are as not being measurable but as defined by us. The idea of the self-concept focuses on how we see ourselves. It challenges clients to construct their own understanding of their careers. Super sees career identity as involving other people, hindi lang to self-journey. It involves other people in your lives, positive or negative involvement in our lives. Super shows how other people are an integrated part of our identity and so encourages us to consider them as well. We do not just decide on our own because we want to, we also try to consult other people like our parents. And lastly, Super describes career as involving other spaces other than work. Marami po tayong life roles according to Super. We are a child, a student, worker, partner, parent, citizen, homemaker, leisureite, and pensioner. Kumisa lahat yun sabay-sabay, no? So sabi ni Super, okay lang yun, ina-acknowledge natin yun. He said that social spaces we inhabit make up who we are. Kung ano yung primary life role natin, it is very evident and very transparent on how we behave, how we think, and what we say. Paano natin gagamitin yung Suke Super kapag gagawa na tayo ng career guidance? Gumagawa ba tayo ng career guidance program? Oo, gagawa tayo. When we talk about the career guidance program, that is just one component of the comprehensive guidance program. No? Meron tayong comprehensive guidance program and under guidance curriculum is career guidance. So, nakapasok siya. So first, the implications of Super's theory for career counseling. Identify the career development stage and set goals for mastery of the task unique to each stage. Kapag gumawa ka ng activity, kapag high school ka, doon ka mag-focus kung ano yung kailangan niyang malaman sa sarili niya. Ano yung aptitude niya, ano yung interest niya, ganun, no? Nandun tayo sa stage na yun. And from there, because of that identification, masiset natin yung goals for that stage. Help student clarify self-concept because any task that enhances self-knowledge will increase vocational maturity. It's very crucial for us to facilitate self-awareness to our students. Paano natin nagagawa yun? Meron ba tayong mga self-assessment tools sa ating office? Because kahit naman sa ating mga matatanda, diba, the more na makilala mo ang sarili mo, the more na maiintindihan mo yung sarili mo. So for our students, the more that they are becoming aware of themselves, the more na magiging mature sila in their vocation. Expose students to a wider range of careers because occupational options narrow over time. Maglang tayo doon sa school, kung meron tayong mga gusto pumunta, Rotary of Tarlac here, yung Central Tarlac, they're very active with this, no? Yung pupunta sila sa school nyo, you don't need to pay them, they give it for free. Nagkakabakondak sila ng career orientation. Huwag nyo kulong yung mga estudyante nyo na mag-aral lang sila ng math, science, English. Kapag meron mga opportunities, expose them to these opportunities. Marami naman pong available. Dolly also comes to the school free. Nasabi nga ni Ma'am kanina, no? Kung minsan nagpapamerienda pa sila. So, i-drop po natin yung mga opportunities na yun. And lastly, direct work experiences are vital. Try on roles in real worlds of work. Kapag high school lang estudyante mo, kapag grade school, paano mo gagawin to? syempre hindi pa lang sila pwede mag-OJT, di ba? How do they get an experience of the work itself? Through job shadowing sa mga parents nila. No? Paano ba yung ginagawa ng nanay nila sa office? So job shadowing pwede naman yun. For more information, I've included all the references I've used for this module. May question po ba? Ay, wala. Yay. We now proceed to the second one.